guys, what's up? Flex Sammy here to talk about Cold War. Now, TGR and Long Sensation and others have reported on the upcoming layout for the new Warzone map, and there are some things that I feel people haven't caught that are going to be really dope, wicked cool. So this map is a representation by Kalanin, and you can see all the new locations and whatnot. And now many of these locations are obviously Fireteam maps, but there's other locations as well that represent maps going all the way back to World at War. And it seems people may not realize it yet. In Black Ops 4 and Blackout, there were certain areas also based off of zombie maps, and this will be no different. But I'll get into that in a second. Ruka Slopes and Sanitarium are areas in maps that we either have or are going to have very soon in Black Ops Cold War, Fireteam and whatever, Dirty Bomb. But then you have areas like Dugga and Zoo. Now, Dugga is probably going to be based off of the portion of the campaign, but this will also have an area similar to the map Grid from Black Ops 1. Not to mention one area is named Zoo, which is also a dope map from Black Ops 1. And it makes sense that they would add Black Ops 1 maps to this game, considering they're adding Black Ops 1 multiplayer maps in the next season. And this game is literally a sequel to Black Ops 1, so yeah. But I think one of the zombie elements for this Warzone map will definitely be in the swamp area. Now, in the swamp area, there's also a chemical lab. And the swamp is kind of a maze, similar to Shinonuma. So I believe this is going to be one of the zombie elements to this portion of the map, which will be dope. There's also an area called Battery, and there is a World at War multiplayer map called Battery. And it's a really cool facility, but it's near shallow waters, and that's where it kind of gets suspicious. And I know the further you go down this left coastline, you're going to find water on the map of Warzone, but I don't know if this area is far down enough to be near the water. But at the same time, the new Warzone map is also taking place in the Ural Mountains, not necessarily Verdansk, somewhere in Russia, which sounds like the whole thing, or at least most of it, is getting decimated and completely rearranged and redone. So there could be shallow water in that area, who knows? But it could just be a new area to Warzone specifically in this Warzone map, like Glova, Mines, and Weather Station. Also, there's going to be tons of throwbacks to previous Treyarch games, more so than we saw in Blackout. Now, this map is supposed to drop on the anniversary or within days of the anniversary of Warzone, so we're probably not going to be seeing it drop within the next week or so, but it's pretty cool. That's pretty much all I got. If you like this video or if you are excited about this, please comment down below. If you're going to press the snooze button, please comment down below and let me know why. Like, share, subscribe, keep the conversation going, and I will catch you guys next time.